My daughter is an art history major, getting her Ph.D. in Renaissance art, of all things. So I gave her a call just to kind of talk about, so what does a Renaissance mean to you, and how would you see it applying to Silicon Valley? But the whole phenomena of the Renaissance was one of recovering from the Dark Ages and going back to a lot of classics, whether it was in the art or in the sciences, and then an intense era of learning, discovery, free thinking, tying back to those classic principles, and the period, the amount of advancement that took place during that was just incredible. Whether it was in art, whether it was in sculpture, whether it was in architecture. Architecture was one of the main focus points. Science, of course. And I was trying to draw a parallel with her in thinking about Silicon Valley. And the thing is that's really what's going on here. We didn't have a Dark Ages, as I would describe it, in the 19th century by any means. But what's going on in electronics, and in the people here are very much, in my mind, what must have gone on with the sculptors, the artists, the architects, the scientists. A whole new world opening up every day because of the free thinking and the amount of learning that would take place in a given day would lead to a whole new set of learning the next day and a whole new set of progress the following day. And so what must have gone on in that period must be very, very similar to what's going on now. And the ability to solve problems mathematically, whether it's a business problem or analyze, whether it's a business problem or a scientific problem, do it as rapidly as we do today, and to share that information as real time as we do today, is going to have, has had, and will continue to have an enormous, profound impact. It's probably the funnest time in my life right now to see the rate of change going on, and I only wish that I could be around 50 years from now to see what the impact will be, because it's going to be incredibly profound.